Hello friends, welcome back to our channel. So in today's session we'll discuss about one more concept in JavaScript, that is arrays. So till now we have seen a normal variable which can hold only one value, but arrays is another type that can hold multiple values under same name. For example, if where a is equal to 10, so this is a normal variable which can hold only one value, and if where some a is equal to square braces comma separated values, so this gives an array. That means all these four elements will be stored under the same name, okay, under the same name. So this type of thing we call it as arrays, right? So these arrays can have not only the same data type, but it can also hold multiple data types. For example, b is equal to some 10, 5.4, abc. So that means here we are having integer, float, string. So we can save all the different data types under the same name, right? So this is called arrays. That means a variable which can hold multiple values is called an array. So how to create an array? How to create? So an array can be created in two ways. One is with the help of declaration, at the time of declaration itself. So any variable, so it may be a array variable or a normal variable, that should be declared with the help of where keyword. So the first way to create an array is where some a is equal to open the square braces and give the multiple elements comma separated elements in the square brackets, like so 10, some 20, some 30 and some 40. So total of four elements are available in array A. So this is one way to create an array. Otherwise you can also go with an empty array. So this will create an empty array. Okay, and the second way to create an empty array, an array, is so using a new keyword. So using new keyword, so similar which we have discussed in the numbers concept. So where a is equal to new array of, here you can pass the elements, right? So this is also an array. Okay, this is one way to create and this is another way to create. So even though the data type of a is array, but in JavaScript, the data type of A will be treated as an object. So if you go with the type of A, so we have already discussed about this type of A, that will return as object. So even though the A is of array, it will return an object, right? Now, how to create an empty array? So single element. So if you consider in the first case, if you go with a is equal to 10, that implies array holds only one value, that is a 10. And coming to the second case, where a is equal to new of array of 10. So this doesn't mean a single element. So it will create an empty array with 10 elements. So here in this case, that means in the second case, if you give only one argument in the array function, that will treat as a length of array. Length of array. So that means the JavaScript will consider it as a 10 elements. So maximum of 10 elements. The size of the array. It will specify the size of the array. If you go with a 10 comma 20, then it will be considered as an array with 2 elements. Array with 2 elements. Right? So that's the difference between the first way and the second way. So I will show you by executing a code in the system. Okay. So once I will, once this syntax has been completed, then we'll move on to the system and I will show you the execution of all these things. Right. Yeah. So these are the two ways to create an array. Now, there is a property called length property. This also we have already seen in the string function. So length property. So in order to know the size of the array, we need to go with this length property. property, right? So for example, if you consider this one, we have to go with a dot length. Automatically it will return the size of the array. That means how many number of elements available in that array, size of array. So in this case it will return 4. It will return 4. And so this is a length property. Now the next question is how to access the elements. How can we access the elements? Because only one variable can hold a lot of elements, right? So how to access the elements? And these elements can be accessed using index values. Using index values. Okay, so this index values always starts from 0 onwards. Always starts from 0 onwards, right? So if you consider this one 10, 20, 30 and 40, so this is the index value 0, this one index value 1, this is the second index, this is the third index. So this can be accessed with the help of array name subscript index number. Similarly, array name subscript index number. Similarly, array name index subscript index array name subscript and index, right? So this is how we can access the elements. So this is called numbered index. Numbered index. So because the index will be considered with the help of numbers, numeric values. So that's why this type of things we call it as a numbered index. So we can also access the elements with the help of named index. So that means instead of using the numbers, we can also use names. So that is how we will see now. For that purpose, for that named indexes, okay, named index. That means in order to access the elements by using the named index, we need to create an array in such a way that where a is equal to curly braces. So give the name for the element. Okay, we can give the name for the element, colon, give the value here, some a, b, c. And second element, give the name for second element. So if it is a string, you have to enclose in quotations, right? So some 1, 2, 3, give the third element, some 80, right? So this is an array. Now, how to access this element? So this element can be accessed with the help of named index. So a dot name. A dot name, it will give the result as ABC. Similarly, A dot R number, that means roll number, it will give some 123. So similarly, A dot percentage, it will return 80. So these type of accessing the elements are called as named index, with the help of named index. So this is a numbered index and this is a named index. So I will show you by executing code, no problem, right? So this is how we can access the elements. Now, how to access by using a loops? Okay, access using a loops. Using a loops, simply, for example, if you consider some variable a is equal to some 10, 20, 30 and 40 and go with the loop for. So here you can know the index value of 10, 0, the index value of 20, 1, the index value of 30, 2, index value of 43. So for, you know the syntax for the for loop, give the loop variable initialization, I is equal to 0, I less than a dot length, okay, a dot length, I plus plus. So immediately you can print here. Some, you know, we know the output statements. So document.writeln or windows.lr or document.getElementById. So one, use one among all those threes. So just use the output statement. I will go with the writeln and print a of i. So for the first iteration, I becomes 0. So it will be a of 0. I will be incremented and immediately I a of 1, a of 2. And a of 3, whenever I is incremented, now 4, right? A value is a 4. Sorry. So here it will print everything. Yeah, it will print everything. Whenever I becomes 3, 3 plus plus, now I becomes 4. So 4 less than a dot length 4. So 4 less than 4 is a false. 4 less than false is a false. So automatically it will print these elements directly. So 10, in the next iteration 20, next iteration 30, next iteration 40 will be printed. So this is how we can access the elements by using a looping statement. You can also use the while loop also. Okay, so this is how we can use. And then the next one is how to change the elements. How can we change the elements? So changing the elements means reassigning the values. For example, consider the array A is equal to some 10, 20, 30 and a 40. So if you go with a A of 0 is equal to some 100, automatically whatever the element available in this index, that will be replaced with a 100. So now you can observe, so A of 0 means 10, right? A of 0 means 10. So here we are using some assignment operator. So if you are using any assignment operator, whatever the computations done on the right hand side, that will be computed and the result will be stored on the left hand side. So left hand side is A of 0. So automatically in the place of 0th index, 100 will be placed. So if you print A, automatically we will get some 100, 20, 30 and a 40. This will be displayed. Okay, and see, if you go with A of 5 is equal to 60, A of 5 is equal to 60. You can observe here the index values are from 0, 1, 2 and 3. Okay, there is no 4th index, there is no 5th index, right? But still we are assigning a value to the index 5. So automatically it will go with the index 5 and it will store 60, and coming to the 4, it will be undefined. Okay, undefined. So now the value for 5th index will be 60, and without a 4 we can't go with the 5. So 4th index will be created and the value will be undefined, and immediately the 5th index will be created and the value will be stored in the 5th index, right? So this is how we can assign a value beyond the length also, beyond the length, right? Then, so this is all about our reassignment. Okay, reassignment or adding the elements. We can also add or we can reassign the elements. And coming to the deletion, so how can we delete? So by using delete keyword. So delete, give the array name and the index. So A of 1, automatically from the array A, whatever the value available in 1, index 1, that will be deleted. So this will be deleted. The space not will be, the space will not be deleted, only the value will be deleted. So if you print A, we will get the result as 100, and we have removed the value at index 1. So we will get undefined. So the value or the space will not be deleted. So next 30, next 40, again undefined, 60. So this will be the result after deleting the element at first index. And if you move with the second index, so 30 will also be deleted, and in place of 30 will get undefined, another undefined, right? So only the element will be deleted but not the space. Okay, the memory will not be released, the memory will be allocated with the undefined symbols, undefined. Okay, unless you add an element at that particular index, it will show the undefined, right? So this is how we can delete the elements. Now how to know whether the variable is an array or a normal variable? So for that purpose we are having a function called isArray function. isArray. So isArray function, so array dot isArray. This will give a true or false, right? So if this function returns true, automatically here we have to give some array name. Array name should be given here. Okay, array name should be given. So if it returns true, that implies the name of the variable given here is an array. If it is false, it's not an array. Example, see. So here we have created some A, right? Here we have created some A. Now we can check array dot is array. So is array, in is array a must be capital of a. So this will return true. So that implies a is a array. So if you go with the type of, if you check with the type of a, it will return as an object. Even though it is an array, it will return an object. So in order to check the whether it is an array or not, you have to use this function. And for example, variable n is equal to 10. That means n holds the numbers. Now array dot is array of n, it will give as a false. It will return false because the argument, that means the name of the variable, this is not an array, this is a number. So automatically we'll get a false as a result. But in this case, this is an array. So automatically we'll get the result as true. So this is how we can check whether the given variable is an array or a normal object or the any number. Right? So hope you understood this one, all of you. Let's stop here, and in the next session we'll discuss about different methods of array. And now we'll move on to the system, and I will demonstrate all these things by executing a small HTML code. Right? So let's move on to the system. Hello friends. So just now we have seen the theoretical part of array introduction, that means how to create an array, how to access the elements, and how to get the length of the array, and how to add more number of elements, and how to delete the elements. All these things we have seen now theoretically. Just now we'll see the practical orientation, that means we'll demonstrate all these things by executing a small code. So let us take the notepad and let's start writing the code with the HTML tags. So inside the HTML tags we need to write a body, and inside the body we'll write the script, right? So inside the body, just go with the heading. So we'll give some heading arrays, and then start writing the script. Now inside the script, first let us create an array. So in order to create an array, the creation of array can be done in two ways. So one is without using a new keyword, and another one is with using a new keyword. Let us check it. Where a is equal to, open the square braces, give the comma separated values and close, and you can go with the document dot write ln and go with the a, and also give the break row so that our next execution will be printed in the next one. So first save this one. So I will save this one with the arrays.html so that it was displayed in desktop. So you can observe here, just double click on this, we'll execute, we'll get C. This is the array. Now what is the type of this array? So in order to get any variable type, we are using some type of keyword. So I think in the previous session we have seen that. Now we'll check type of a plus give the break row for the next, right? Now we'll get the output as object. So in JavaScript, arrays will be represented as an object itself. So even though you are creating an array, it will be created as an object. Next, the second way of creating an array is array a is b is equal to using a new keyword. So I will show you the difference, why we have to go with this one and all these things. So 50, 60, 70 and 80. Okay. So here also I have created some four variables, so four values in that array, right? And here also you can print document dot write ln b plus go with the break row for the next output. See, 50, 60, 70, 80. Again, there are. Now, if you want to create a single element, where variable c is equal to single element some 100. Okay, 100. I am giving some 100. Now, go with the same thing. So, document dot write ln c plus go with the break row for the next output. See, what is the value? 100. Perfect. And go with the d is equal to new array of 100. Now just go with this one, document dot write ln
D plus give the break rate for the next output. So you can observe here. So what we got? All commas. Because this statement, so particularly this statement will create a single element for the array, but if you are using new keyword, it will create 100 elements with a undefined values, 100 elements. So this is the size. In this statement, 100 is a size. It will treat 100 as a size, right? So if you want to add a more number of elements, we can go with this one. So this way, we can create this way. And for inserting, we are having a lot of functions. We are having some push function and a pop function that we'll discuss in the next session. So this is how we can create an array by using a normal way and by using the new keyword. And now how to get the length of the array? Simply go with the length property, write ln. So here we are having some a is equal to 4 elements. So a dot length, or simply give the text. So length of array A is, and go with this one, plus A dot length. This will directly gives the length of the array and give the break row for the next output. So you can get here length of array is 4. Length of array A is 4. So you can observe 10, 20, 30, 40. So total four elements are there. Okay. So this is how we can find the length of the array. And then how to access the elements. So we can access the elements with the help of index values. Here also there will be index values, and the index values will always start from 0. So by using the index values, we can access the arrays. So let us check here. So document dot write ln. And here elements plus, or we can simply go with the first element, okay, first element plus how we can give a of 0, we'll give the first element plus give the break row for the next term. See, first element 10. So give some space so that we'll get the clear, right? First element is 10, right? Similarly, we can, if you go with the second element, if you want to go with the second element, what is the second element index? It's a 1. So second element is 20, and the third element will be 30, fourth element will be 40. So like that, by using the index values, we are supposed to access the elements. And now, how to print this one? Okay, how to print that one? So simply by giving this one, we can print the complete array. Okay, so simply by you giving the array name, we can get the complete array. And there is a one more way to access the elements, that is a named index. So these are called numbered index, because with the help of numbers, so in the subscript we are giving some numbers, based upon the numbers we are accessing the elements. So there is another way to access the elements, that is a named elements. So in such, for that purpose, we will have to create the array in such a way where e is equal to, open the curly brace, so give the name. Instead of using index values, we are giving some name for all the elements, some A, B, C, and give the roll number. So if it is a string, we need to give in the double quotations. So 1, 2, 3, okay, and go with the percentage, colon, give the percentage, some 80, and close the curly braces. So this is also an array, okay, this is also an array. But here, if you go with this one, write ln of E, see, you'll get some object. Okay, here you'll get some object. If you want to access the elements, go with the named index, e dot name. It will give the name of the element. Okay, name of the particular element. Plus, break row. So the next will be added here. So e dot array dot element name, named index. Okay, similarly again go with the break row so that the output will be printed on the next one. So e dot percentage plus give the break row. Now you can observe we can get the elements with the help of named indexes. So this is a named index, okay, whereas here this is a numbered index. So with the help of numbered index we are accessing the elements, but here we are using some names in order to access the elements, right? So preferably it would be preferred with the numbered index, right? So the next one is the looping. So how can we display all the elements one by one? So use a statement. So here you can have for loop I is equal to 0, and you know the property, length property, I less than a dot length. So you know a is having some 10 20 30 40 elements, so I plus plus, and just print here document dot write ln, go with the a of I plus. So each and every element will be printed in a new line here. So you can observe here. So each and every element will be printed in a new line. So you can observe here 10, 20, 30, 40. Okay. So just I will increase the font size. Document dot write ln H2. So you can get it, right? So 10, 20, 30, 40. So these elements will be printed in a line by line. That is, we are using some iterative statements and we are printing the elements of a array, right? So how to change the elements? That means reassignment. How to change the elements? That is a reassignment. So we know that. So document dot write ln, a is equal to. See, here we will go with the A plus. Now you can observe here. So A is equal to some 10, 20, 30, 40, right? So here we'll go with this one. Okay, instead of going this one, we'll write here. Okay, so just remove this one. So in order to understand, I'm writing like this. So you can observe a is equal to 10. Okay, so here also you can go with the is equal to, see, a of 0 is equal to 10, 20, 30, 40. Now I just want to reassignment. Okay, I want to do the reassignment. A of 0 is equal to, I will go with the 100. Now again, just display the a value here we have to write document dot write ln. A of 0, now it is 100, right? So previously it was 10, now I have reassigned the value. So automatically the element which is available at 0th index is replaced with the 100. So the updated array is 100, 20, 30, 40. So this is how we can update the elements. Let me change the elements. And how to delete the elements. So if you delete any element, so we can delete the elements by using the delete keyword. So delete, give the value, that means specify the index. So a of for example 1, so the element present at the index value 1 will be deleted, and the space will not be removed. That means some undefined space will be available there itself. It just only deletes the element. So now I will show you. So first we will get the length of a, okay, length of array A is a dot length. This is the property, right? NGTH property, and go with the break row. Now you can observe the length of array A is 4. Now I am deleting the element delete A of 1. So just this statement will delete the element present at the index value 1. Now if you go with document dot write ln and the same thing, just copy the same thing, A after deleting, element with index 1. Now this is the statement we are giving after deletion. Still the length is 4. Okay, still the length is 4. Now you can observe, so what about the, what is the value of A of 1? Okay, because we have already deleted it, right? We have already deleted it. Now if you observe here, just go with the same statement so that we'll get the values of A. You can observe here A of 1 is undefined. That means the space will not be removed, so the space remains the same. So only the value will be deleted. Okay, so the value will be deleted and it will be asterisk. I mean the space will be asterisk. The reference, I mean the space reference will be asterisk. And we can also insert a more number of elements. Like for example, A is having around 4 elements, index 3. If I go with A of 5 or A of 6 is equal to some 200, automatically 6th element will be 200, and previously we are having only 4 elements, right? Only 4 elements, that means a 3rd index. Now I am inserting some index 6, the element at index 6. So what about the index values 4 and 5? Automatically it will be fixed with a space, that means undefined values will be occupied, right? So see, again once again I will go with this one. You can observe here, see, A of 6 is 200 I have given. So here we can write, go after inserting element at 6th index. See, you can observe here. So after again, I have given a wrong statement here, document dot writeln. Writeln, and here we will go with this one. So you can observe after inserting element at 6th index. So you can observe he previously only 3rd index is the last element. Now I have created some 6th index. We are inserting some element in the 6th index. So what about the 4th index and 5th index? So those will be filled with undefined values. Okay. Now array is having some 7 elements with 3 undefined values and 4 defined values. Right. So this is how we can use the elements. We can delete. So if you delete the element by using the delete keyword, the space will remain same. The count of values will be remain same. Right, and here how to know whether the variable is array or not? Because even though it is an array, what we have done, so we are getting some object as a data type, right? So we know that type of A is array. Okay, we know that type of A is array because we have created. So if anyone wants to know whether what is the data type of array A, then if you go with the type of A, we'll get the array as dot write ln. So we'll get the result as object, right? Now there is a function called is array. So if it is an array, automatically it will return true, otherwise it will return false. You can go with document dot write ln. We can go with array dot is array of, you have to pass an argument, that means A. So it will check whether A is an array or not. If you go with here, you can observe true, right? So here the array should be given in the parentheses as an argument. So it will check whether this given name is an array or not, okay? And here you can observe we have created some B, right? So we will check whether B is an array or not. See, it's a true, right? So if it is an array, it will return true. See, where E, for example, where some n is equal to some 10, right? So let us check whether n is an array or not. So you will get some false, because see, you can observe here false, because n is not an array, n is a number, right? So that's why we are getting some false as a result. So this is the function in order to check whether the given variable is of array data type, array or not. So by default the array will be treated as an object, okay? That's why we are supposed to use this function to check whether the variable is an array or not, right? So hope you understood this one. So let's stop here, and if you are having any doubts regarding these arrays introduction concepts, so feel free to post your doubts in the comment section. Definitely I will try to clarify all your doubts. And if you really understood my session, like my session, share my session with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching. Thank you very much.